It's qualifying time at Spa, one of the mightiest tracks on the Formula One calendar. Long straights, up and downhill, Eau Rouge as well. This track isn't for the faint-hearted. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. Do you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on in the corners and max out down the straights?
Top speed is a key factor for this circuit. Even if you can achieve the same lap time as someone running less wing than you, chances are you'll find overtaking difficult if you have too much drag.
Grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Rosberg, Raikkonen, and Sebastian Vettel. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow, where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, it's goodbye. In the 48 races held at Spa between 1950 and 2015, the race winner has only started from pole position on 16 occasions. Qualifying yesterday may have set the order for today, but expect the unexpected here at the Belgian Grand Prix. As the saying goes, of course, anything can happen. And you know what? It usually does. So here we are once again, ready to go racing through the Ardennes Forest. 4.35 miles of long straights, fast corners, and massive elevation changes. It makes this not only one of the most exciting circuits on the calendar, but one that makes for some consistently high-quality racing as well. Simply put it, there really is no place quite like Spa. Joining me to talk you through the action today is Anthony Davidson. And give us an idea of what kind of thing you're going to be looking out for today.
Well, the big question for me is whether or not we're going to see the cars able to follow each other closely enough to overtake, especially through the fast sections here. Of course, we've got DRS, and that will help on the straights, but it's still no good if you're coming off the previous corner too slowly or too far behind.
OK, don't worry about making plans. spaces into one, it's far too tight. Concentrate on a clean exit so you get good momentum down the camel straight.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Nico Rosberg will start his silver arrow from pole position, and Kimi Raikkonen completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Hamilton, Sergio Perez, and Verstappen, Massa, Alonso, Sainz, and Roman Grosjean, Bottas, Button, Nico Hülkenberg, and a Red Bull, Harry Anto, Magnussen, Esteban Gutierrez, and Daniel Kvyat, Palmer, and Nasser, Marcus Ericsson, and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. Brilliant stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. It's a good result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going for someone who really punched above their weight here today, and that's Felipe Massa. He was fantastically quick through the whole Grand Prix.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time though, goodbye. We'll be right back.